Indeed, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It's very nice to be invited to play in the Blackpool Tower. I haven't played here for some time, and this afternoon I'm completely not at home on the organ because of the way we've had to sort of just come in and set up. So it's rather difficult, so I hope you'll bear with me. We're from Brighton, for the uninitiated. That's the other B place. Blackpool and Brighton. Brighton's a lovely place to come from. Not much good to go to, but lovely to come from. Anyway, I'm going to start by playing, I don't know if you know, but this week is National Smile Week. And I'm looking out in your faces. It's not working. All these tunes that I'm going to play to you in this little medley are all about smiling. So if you want to join in with some of these songs and give a smile, that would be absolutely lovely.
Thank you.
I'm going to ask you to use your imagination, because I'm going to try and find in the organ here a way of sort of demonstrating some of the sounds that perhaps you're not familiar with in the instrument. I ask you to use your imagination because we're going to visit a very small village and pass by all the uninteresting little shops where we come across this clock store. And in the clock store, there are various types of clocks, cuckoo clocks, alarm clocks, chiming clocks. And to assist the clockmaker, there is an assistant, and he has a very infectious little whistle, which I'm hoping I'll be able to find on this organ. So this piece is called In a Clock Store.
Thank you. Thank you.
very kind. That last piece, of course, was Canadian Capers, and I remember as a small girl, a boy, in my pram, listening to that, Reginald Dixon actually playing it on an old 78 record. I don't know where that went, but I expect it to have a good home now, if it's still alive. And that encouraged me to play the organ in the first place. So, I thought it would be best now. I am not a dance player, I have to tell you that. But as we have so many dances this afternoon, I thought it would be rather appropriate if I finished off with some little tunes that you can get up and dance to. Don't expect any fantastic tempos, will you? Speak to me, for God's sake. I have enjoyed myself playing the Tower well, and I shall look forward to playing to our organ cupcake customers later on this evening. But meanwhile, this is John Mann signing off from Sussex by the Sea, and hoping that you will be able to trip the front like fantastic. Now, supposing I started with a bit of a quick step, what would be the tempo for that? Let's have a go anyway. ladies and gentlemen, let's keep that applause going for a man from Sussex by the Sea, John Mann. A great 45 minutes of musical entertainment there from one of the best in the business. A wonderful sound of John Mann. Thank you, John, that was lovely. Once again, man from Sussex by the Sea, John Mann. Thanks, John, that was lovely. Next gentleman to play for you.
See what I've got in here tonight. Oh my. Well, listen, it's been such a long time since I've managed to play for the Cavalcades.
Hands up those that have never even heard me play before. Just raise your right arm. Don't worry about it. It's just something. You see, there's some newcomers over, and some over there. You see, because I think I'm famous. I don't want to fool myself for much longer. Because if I leave it too long, it'll be too late. Hands up those that have heard me play before. Oh, isn't that lovely? In such clean hands. Hands up all those that couldn't care ruddy less one way or the other. I didn't like that. Anyway, all right, thank you very much. I've seen quite enough. Quite enough. I came up from Brighton actually yesterday because that, you know, to save me the drive, because it's such a long way, isn't it? And you know, I started out and I haven't got very far when all of a sudden a little bit of this was doing a bit of that. So of course I did a bit of that. And I wound the window down and I said, "Where are you going, dear?" She said, "I'm on my way to Blackpool." So I said, "Well, what a bit of luck, get in." Well, we hadn't been driving very long and I was sitting there, not a word was spoken, when all of a sudden she turned to me and she said, "Here, can you drive with one hand?" I said, "Yes, why?" She said, "Well, wipe your nose, it's running." Wasn't that a lovely introduction from Chris? All about the butcher. And they don't come much butcher than him, I tell you. Oh, he's a boy, isn't he? I think. I must stop that. Listen, here are a few tunes that are getting your foot tapping and your fingers going. And the adrenaline. You can put the house lights out now, Cole, because I've seen. Oh, that's better. Oh, shall we all hold hands and contact the living? You want to look at yourselves from up here. These tunes are, in other words, to get the adrenaline going. There are a little first bit that says to itself, "I got rhythm." I'm not trying.
Bye.
And I'm feeling it every day. I went to the doctor the other day. I said, "Doctor, how do I stand?" He said, "God knows, don't ask." You know, some years ago, there was an organist, because it's not only me, you see. There's dozens of them. And he came over from Germany by the name of Mr. Klaus Wunderlich. You remember Klaus? Yeah. And of course, at that particular time, we all raced to see, you know, if he was really like he sounded on his discs at that time. Of course, it was LPs, wasn't it? And I was one of those that too went along. And at that time, I watched him, listened to him play, and he's, I thought, what a miserable sound, because he didn't smile much, did he? You know, and of course, he made out he couldn't speak English. Donner and Blitzer and all that. And anyway, he was playing at that particular time an overture which was new to us. I'd never heard it, and I know some of my colleagues, we were all trying to sort of find out where we could find the music, and I was one of the lucky ones. I managed to get a copy, and I brought it along tonight.
Because this overture, you being a musical audience, this is just intended for you.
The overture is called Bagatelle, and it's written by a chap called Joseph Richter, whoever he is. And so I thought it would be worth explaining to you what the overture is all about, because it is rather unusual. Well, I open the page and start at the beginning. And it says here, Allegro Vivace, which, in case you're not aware of, means ruddy fast. And it goes like the clappers. And you will think to yourself, you'll never keep that up. But I can. I'll give you my Shelley number. Now, then we get... No, please, this is not a place of entertainment. Then there is a cadenza here that walks up. I don't suppose you can see in this congealed lighting, but it looks as though a fly has got an ink pot, got drunk, and walked up the page. I think that is a bit, actually. Don't think that should be there. And then there's a slow cello sound which comes up like that, and then I do a few ripples on the harp. But don't worry about it, you won't need a harp where you lot are going. Mind you, I'll see you there. And then I turn the page, and this rather lovely waltz tune starts, a rather little sort of jousy sound about it, and you will think to yourself, what's he talking about? We know that, but you don't, because it is sort of on that sort of level of jousy stuff. It's rather nice, it's a beautiful sounding waltz, but for some extraordinary reason, when it gets over to this page, it violently changes key. It is a violent change, musically, it is. It goes into four flats. Oh, he moved four times. Oh. It was got the addresses down here. You've paid for this. Anyway, this waltz tune starts off in this other different sort of mode, and then finally down the bottom here, it finishes and it goes a bit animated. It goes, I play in triplets like that, sort of a bit like a fairy, really. And I turn the page over, and this flaming waltz tune starts all over again. But it doesn't last very long, because down here, I put the trumpet stops on the organ, and there's a fanfare. And you'll think, well, somebody's going to walk on. But they won't. I shall see to that. And then it goes on again, this waltz tune, and it suddenly builds up and builds up. And I turn the page over like this, and this part is very deep, and you'll notice that my left hand's going like the clap as it is. Which is unusual, because I'm right-handed as a rule, but it makes it difficult, do you know what I mean? You're ahead of me, aren't you? You're talking... I think I'm at the right do, aren't I? Then we get down to here, and then there's another one of these sort of cadenzas in one key along on this line, and then another cadenza in another key along this line. Sounds most odd. But I didn't write the damn thing. Then I turn the page over,
Oh no, we're on the home and straight now. This only lasts 3/4 of an hour. It is once again marked presto, which is faster than allegro vivace. And it's not presto just like that. This is fast. And I can tell you, it's a fast piece. This bit is more reminiscent of the can-can. This, you know, the up and down thing, off and back. And I really get worked up here. I really do. I get with it, do you know what I mean? And I get so emotional, and this really works up so quickly, my little legs are a blur. And finally it culminates into a great big splodge of notes on the end there, which is standing ovation. So ladies and gentlemen, may I play you this overture, Bagatelle? Maybe it might be a good idea if I had a bit of applause before I start. Thank you. God, is that all I'm going to get? I'm going to play Danny Boy instead.
Thank you.
musicians, jugglers, magicians, the man on the flying trapeze. There are lowdown sopranos who sit on pianos, but I don't go for any one of these. I only go to see a show so I can watch a song and dance man. He's got a style that makes a sad heart smile. In cabaret, where life is gay, you're bound to find a song and dance man. And on that stage, he's all the rage. He'll serenade a lovely lady with a parasol. He'll dance around her finger by the garden wall. When they go and hide behind that parasol, do you think they really kiss? I only go to see a show so I can watch a song and dance. Ooh, man, I lost this last week. It's taken a fortnight to get the smile off my face. Kind of entertainment. The wonderful entertainment. The kind of entertainment for me. That was a little shortish. Now we have the lovely waltzes of Irving Berlin.
you all about the next dance. Here is the lovable character, the one and only Mr. Pastry.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to imagine, if you will, that we are in a Victorian ballroom, crowded with dancers, about to dance. The Lancers. Thank you.
Bring your cameras down, take some pictures when he comes back.